Hello, first graders. Welcome back to our virtual field trip. This is field trip number 2. I'm so excited you guys were able to join me. Quick, before I get started, I have a little joke for you guys since it is joke day. What is the only waterfall in the world that will laugh at all of your jokes? It's Mini Haha Falls. All right, boys and girls, this is where I'm at today. I am at Mini Haha Falls. This is located in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Now, Minneapolis is just about 25 minutes away from you guys, so you guys can make this a quick day trip with your family if you're looking to do something outside, adventure. It's an absolutely beautiful area. It's one of Minnesota's oldest regional parks. It attracts over 850,000 tourists every year. So it's pretty cool to explore. They have a lot of hiking trails. They have a picnic area, a playground, a park. So if you're looking for something to do and get out of the house, come on down to Minnehaha Falls and you guys will surely have a great time. A little bit about Minnehaha Falls is it comes from the water source of Minnehaha Creek, which comes from Lake Minnetonka. So Minnehaha Creek flows from Lake Minnetonka and it goes all the way to the Mississippi River. So boys and girls, if you remember our Okie Dokie Brothers concert, they had the song M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. Now that is where it came from. It's coming from the this goes to the Mississippi River, and that's where the song came from, was the Mississippi River. So it's pretty cool. It's falling over these limestone rocks. There's a ton of other wildlife here. The waterfall is 53 feet tall, so it's a pretty big waterfall. If you guys come out here, I know you're gonna really enjoy it. This is going to be waterfall number 1 of our field trip, and tune in with me for waterfall number 2. Okay, so we'll see you soon for waterfall number 2. Hello, first graders. Welcome back to the virtual field trip, and here we are at waterfall number 2. I am here at Hidden Falls Regional Park in St. Paul, Minnesota. Okay, so this waterfall is actually about only 2-3 miles away from Minnehaha Falls. Even though it's so close, it does not come from the same water source. So Hidden Falls is actually a spring-fed creek, which means that it's an underground water resource. It's very fresh. It's very natural. It'll take compacted snow, turn that into the water. It'll take rainwater, and it just keeps free-flowing, and it's a really cool thing. So this creek, it's in about it's a very short hike, only about 0.2 miles to hike up to here, but overall here at the park you do actually have over 3 miles of hiking trails. So this is another great place for you guys to come out, explore. This is kind of a secret hidden waterfall, hence the name. It says Hidden Falls. It really is hidden. You don't get to see it straight up from the river or any place. You have to hike a little bit to find it, but it's so great. It's beautiful. This waterfall is only about 15 feet tall compared to the 53-foot tall Minnehaha waterfall, but it's still an awesome place to come adventure. There's that limestone. There's plenty of rocks. You guys can do some rock climbing, hiking, like I said. Not only is there that fall, but here's the creek that it runs off into. Now this creek keeps on going, and it actually does flow into the Mississippi River, I believe, because the Mississippi River is just a little bit further up the road, and it's a really special place for you guys to come visit. So that's about all I have for Hidden Falls here. I hope you enjoyed it. Now I'm going to go on to waterfall number 3. Okay, so we'll see you at waterfall number 3. Hello, first graders. Welcome back to the virtual field trip. I am standing here on the Stone Arch Bridge in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Just over my shoulder, you can see the Guthrie Theater, so that's a pretty cool place. But I am at the location of my third waterfall I wanted to show you. So I am here at St. Anthony Falls in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Okay, So this is in Minneapolis. It's a little bit further away from Minnehaha and Hidden Falls. But St. Anthony Falls is actually the first waterfall on the Mississippi River. And in 1860, they actually had to put a concrete wall over the natural landscape of the waterfall because of Minnesota's lumbering industry. With how many logs that were floating down the river, it was running into the waterfall and breaking it apart. And in order to keep this thing going and moving, they had to put a wall over it so that they could continue to use the river as shipping for lumber. But this is a pretty cool waterfall. It's a little bit bigger than Hidden Falls, a lot wider than Minnehaha Falls, probably not quite as tall as Minnehaha Falls, but it is much wider. This is on the Mississippi River, okay? So if you and your family ever have a chance, I would say come on down to the Stone Arch Bridge, get the overlook of the waterfall. You can get an overlook of Minneapolis skyline. This is a wonderful place to be. I would say you could come over here. You know, if you guys want to go biking, you could bring your bikes, go down the trails here. You could certainly hike as well, but you can also take in the historic St. Anthony waterfalls. All right, boys and girls, that is my last waterfall I have to show you today. So please go ahead, do something fun with these waterfalls. Maybe build your own waterfall, or maybe go out, explore, and find your own, create your own waterfall. See if you can do something like that. I'd love to see how creative you first graders can get. But until next time, I will see you for our next virtual field trip. All right, bye, first graders.